Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, prayerful greetings of love, peace, joy, and good health to all. We are entering into a new liturgical year with the celebration of Kudos Ito Sunday on 31st October 2021. The Sunday that comes immediately after 30th October is considered as Kudos Ito, and it marks the beginning of the liturgical calendar. Kudos Ito is the feast of the sanctification of the Church. The Church is the body of Christ, which has been sanctified by the selfless service offered on the cross. This sanctity of the Church is to be maintained by the members of the Church through living a life of love and mission. The primary question which reverberates in our mind during the period of Kudos Ito is, "Who do you say that I am?" Matthew 16:15. Standing at the foot of the cross and experiencing the body broken and the blood shed for us, we should be able to proclaim from the depth of our heart, "You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God." Matthew 16:16. This experience of the Messiah forms the foundation of the sanctification of the Church and living a life of love and mission. Our love towards God and our fellow brethren should prompt us to extend our hands and hearts to the afflicted, the downtrodden, the alienated, and the thirsty for the word of God. The mission culminates in making them disciples of Christ. As we read in the Gospel of Kudos Ito Sunday, the Lord built his church on Peter, the rock. Today, the church has sustained and grown through our faith and life in Jesus Christ, which should be oriented towards others in love and mission. In love, we are one with the faithful, and in mission, we are becoming one with those who thirst for Christ. The second Sunday of the liturgical year is known as Kudos Ito, the feast of the renewal of the Church. The Church is incessantly renewed through the repentance and the reconciliation of its faithful. The body of Christ continues in sanctity through the regular reception of the sacraments of reconciliation and Holy Eucharist, the observance of the Lent and fasting, the sharing of the Word of God and the Tithe. The experience of renewal in Kudos Ito should extend throughout the liturgical year ahead. We are slowly but steadily coming out of the challenges of the COVID pandemic. I exhort all the faithful of the Eparchy to gradually return to regular reception of the sacraments of reconciliation and Holy Eucharist. Let us sanctify our Eparchy through our lives of love and mission, and renew the grace received in baptism through confession and the reception of the Holy Eucharist. Let us earnestly strive to be regular in church activities as much as possible, keeping in mind the COVID protocol and the safety precautions. The celebration of the Mission Month. The Eparchy celebrated October 2021 as the Mission Month under the auspices of the Eparchical Commission for Evangelization by conducting the mission prayer gatherings, the mission awareness program, and the celebration of the Mission Sunday. The mission family of the Eparchy got invigorated through the mission prayer gatherings conducted from 1st to 22nd October under the leadership of various parishes of the Eparchy. It was a providential experience to pray for the mission with each parish community on these days of prayer gathering. I sincerely hope that the sharing done by the missionaries each day enlightened and encouraged us to be missionaries for Christ through regular prayers for mission, sharing the Word of God, actively visiting the mission areas, and generously contributing for the cause of the mission. I wholeheartedly appreciate the sincere efforts taken by the parish priest and the parish committee, along with the Commission for Evangelization members, to transform these gatherings to a blessed experience. I have clearly noticed a few faithful who were ardently attending the gatherings every day to strengthen the missions through their sacrificial prayer. My sincere gratitude and special blessings for them. The mission awareness program conducted on 23rd October was a unique venture in this regard. The program highlighted the activities undertaken by the Eparchy in 12 different mission areas spread across Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, and Tamil Nadu. I am quite sure that the program was effective in helping you to have a bird's eye view of the missions of the Eparchy and the possible interventions of the faithful in the missions in different ways. I sincerely thank all the missionaries who took effort and spared time, in spite of their busy mission schedule, to present before us the mission activities undertaken by them in various ways. I hope all the parishes of the Eparchy celebrated the Mission Sunday on 24th October in a fitting manner. I hereby remind all the parish priests and the committee members to forward the Mission Sunday collection to the Eparchy Curia as early as possible, latest by 5th November 2021. The amount can be channelized to the missions at appropriate time, as and when needed by each mission. Let us be united in prayer for the missions and generous in contributing for the missions. Mission visit. October being a mission month, I happened to visit most of the missions in the Andhra Telangana region during 10 to 19 October 2021. It was really a memorable journey because of the important events that took place on those days. The visits were mostly together with Father Samuel Theke Kavinal, the Director of Seva, and the lay missionaries Mr. V.A. George, Mr. Sakriya Pawut, and Mrs. Leni Pawut. Blessing of mission houses in Rapalle Mission. Two mission houses were blessed in the Rapalle Mission, Andhra Pradesh. One for the priests and the other for the sisters. Father George Kandathi Parambil, under the guidance of Father Thomas Atimaril, will give leadership to the Rapalle Mission by staying in the mission house, and the Sisters of the Imitation of Christ, SIC, Trivandrum Province, will collaborate with him by staying in the new Bethany Sisters Mission House. The blessing of the Bethany Sisters Mission House was done on 11th October 2021 in the presence of Sister Damashin, SIC, the provincial, and Sister Mahima, SIC, the counselor. Sister Tushara, as I see, and Sister Phagya, as I see, are appointed as missionaries in Raipalle. Being a new mission, Father George and the sisters have begun the initial phase of evangelization. Blessing of a mission chapel at Kripa Nagar in Bapatla. A new mission chapel, St. Alphonsa Malangara Mission Chapel, was blessed at Kripa Nagar in Bapatla Mission on 12th October 2021. This marks the definite growth of the missionary initiatives in Kripa Nagar into a formal community. Receiving the DM sisters to Ongole Mission. We are blessed with another community of sisters in Ongole, Andhra Pradesh. I officially welcomed the DM sisters of St. Joseph's Province, Marthandam, to the Ongole Mission on 13th October 2021. Sister Seraphim DM and Sister Josina DM are assigned as missionaries in Ongole. Currently, they are staying with the Salesian sisters in Ongole and involving in the missions together with Father Paul Petticatin, the mission in charge of Ongole. They are conducting tuition classes and visiting houses on weekdays and attending prayer services on Sundays. Missionaries Meet. I became part of the Missionaries Meet conducted on 14th October at Claritian Retreat Center, Hattiprolu. It was a providential occasion to be with all the priests, sisters, brothers and lay missionaries involved in the Andhra Telangana region. A detailed discussion on the intervention of Seva in the region was conducted under the guidance of Father Samuel Tekekavina. It was a blessed occasion to celebrate the Silver Jubilee of Sister Saumya Diem, who is serving in the Bapatla Mission. Laying of foundation stone for a chapel at Kalvagat in Kaikallur Mission. On 15th October 2021, the foundation stone was laid for building a mission chapel at Kalvagat in Kaikallur. Kalvagat Chapel will become a milestone in the growth of the mission at Kaikallur. Mission exploration in Hyderabad. The lay missionaries of Hyderabad have identified certain missions around Hyderabad, Secunderabad. During this mission visit, I had an initial discussion with some pastors who are working in those missions at Tungi Khalsa, some 50 kilometers away from Hyderabad. I was accompanied by the Hyderabad missionaries, Mr. Sebastian Kane, Mr. Joey Varghese, Mr. Vanoj Mathai, and Mr. Vinod Mathai, and the Eparchy missionaries, Mr. V.A. George and Mr. Zakaria Pawat. I hope and pray that these explorations will pave the way for further progress in the near future. Memorial meetings of Bishop Jacob Mar Barnabas OIC. It was really a God-given experience to participate in the memorial meetings conducted at different levels of the eparchy to recognize the vision and mission of His Excellency Jacob Mar Barnabas Metropolitan. The words echoed in the meetings pierced my heart as a challenge to sacrifice my life for the mission of Christ amongst the poorest of the poor in the mission areas. I gave a clearer vision to my involvement in the missions and enormous strength to move ahead without any fear of failure. His selfless life, fearless decisions, option for the poor, and risk-taking interventions are motivating me to be a strong warrior for Jesus. Annual Retreat of the Priests. The annual retreat of the priests, except the religious, is scheduled to be held from 15 to 19 November 2021 online via Zoom. Most Reverend Rafael Tuttle, Bishop of Shamsabad, will preach the retreat this year. The priests will be free from their regular pastoral, institutional, and other responsibilities during the days of the retreat. All the faithful are expected to follow the arrangements made by the parish priests in their absence. Even though they may be staying in the presbytery during the retreat online, create an atmosphere of prayer and meditation for them. The annual retreat will conclude on 19th November with the priest meet together with the religious priests. I request the prayers of our faithful to accompany us during the days of our retreat. Second anniversary of the Eparchy. We are completing 2 years after the erection of the Eparchy on 23rd November 2019 by His Holiness Pope Francis. Even though the last 2 years were mostly clouded with the deadly scourge of COVID-19, the Eparchy moved ahead through online programs, offline meetings, personal interventions, and missionary endeavors. Let us pray earnestly for all the initiatives of the Eparchy to strengthen the faithful spiritually and ecclesially. Commemoration of Bishop Paulus Marphilexinos. The commemoration of His Grace Paulus Marphilexinos Metropolitan falls on 3rd November. He was a prelate who embraced the Catholic Church when he was the head of the Malabar Independent Syrian Church, or the Toliur Church. His knowledge in Syriac and liturgical discipline are noteworthy. Let his blessed memory be a fortress to us. New appointments in the Eparchy. Father Joshua Tekedet, belonging to the Eparchy of Mavelikkara and assigned to our Eparchy, is appointed to Kaikalur Mission of Andhra Pradesh for 3 months to stay with Father John Maradur and learn Telugu. Thereafter, his definitive ministry will be allotted. Father John Maradur is appointed the Regional Coordinator of Seva, Andhra Pradesh Telangana, and Sister Helen Maria Diem, the Regional Assistant Coordinator of Seva, Andhra Pradesh Telangana, with immediate effect. They will work for the social upliftment of the mission areas in cooperation with Father Samuel Teke Kavinal, the Eparchy Director of Seva. May God bless them abundantly to carry out their responsibility in a committed way. Eparchy preparation for the Synod of Bishops 2023 in Rome. As the Universal Church is preparing for the Synod of Bishops 2023, each Eparchy collaborates through Eparchy deliberations at different levels of the Eparchy, parish, district and Eparchy. The details of the Eparchy preparations are intimated through Circular 10/2021. Parish General Body Meeting. It is more than a year that the General Body meetings of the parishes have not been conducted. Proposals for holding the meetings had to be put off, as the circumstances seem to be limping back to normalcy, but with restrictions, it is opportune to hold the General Body meetings of the parishes. The aforementioned circular gives the necessary directives on this. In my pastoral solicitude for the good of our parishes, I think the life of our parishes can be improved by holding the General Body meetings and conducting elections to the parish committee. May all those responsible strive to complete this process of election according to the norm of law. As I conclude, let me tell you, the observance of the Mission Month and the devotion of the Holy Rosary of the month of October have given ample grace to us individually and as families and communities. Our missions are a blessing to us. Our parish life and activities are now opening up. Let the new liturgical year be a blessing for us all and may help us to grow more in Christ by the action of the Holy Spirit. Let us continue our heavenward pilgrimage. God bless us all. Your Aboon, Thomas Mar Antonius OIC, Bishop of St. Ephraim, Kadiki, Pune.